Welcome to the show. My name is Jeffrey Kerosi for Kerosi TV. Today we have very nice, sweet and juicy stories for you. We will start with the first story. It's looking at Switzerland, whether Switzerland can save the world. Can Switzerland save the world? Switzerland is good. Is a good example of principles of federalism. Switzerland is a good example of principles of federalism. No one knows or cares who is president, unlike in Kenya, where we have a stalemate on who becomes the next president. Factually, all political decisions, from taxes to welfare to immigration, are decided locally. This means that there is proper public participation in Switzerland compared to other countries. The second story is about the torturer-in-chief who is turning into a human rights defender. George W. Bush, you know, you remember George W. Bush, who pushed other countries like Britain and United Kingdom into war with Iraq and other countries like Afghanistan? He is turning into a human rights defender. George W. Bush gave a speech yesterday. He was slamming President Donald Trump for dragging down U.S. from the root of democracy. He said, and I quote him, "We are gathered in the cause of liberty. This is a unique moment," end of quote. Bush was a dangerous person while he was the commander-in-chief of the United States of America. He committed more abuses of power than can be documented in an entire book. Some of the violations of human rights he conducted includes he authorized torture regime, which even most civilized nations had abandoned centuries ago. George W. Bush, some of the torture methods he employed includes tearing out toenails in Afghanistan, beating people to death in Iraq, illegally sending detainees to foreign countries to be tortured. Those are some of the atrocities which were committed by George W. Bush, George Walker Bush of the United States. Now, should we pay for university education? That is an important question around the world. This is a $1 million question globally, because university or higher education has proved to be very expensive around the world. So, who should pay for higher education? Currently, there is a movement towards free university. There is a group of people all over the world, a movement, it's a large group of people who are advocating for free university education. Earlier this week, New York became the first United States of America state to offer free college tuition, save for the rich. So in New York, a law has been passed to offer free education for the poor or the poorest people in the society, while the rich will still be required to pay tuition fee to the universities in the state. But elsewhere in the United Kingdom, the Labour Party pledged to abolish fees entirely in 2017 manifesto of free education. I've pointed out that fees is a source of inequality and leads to falling enrollments. Fees excludes young people from disadvantaged backgrounds from accessing higher education. This is very true, whatever part of the world you are talking from. I'm talking from Kenya, where it is true, if you don't have money, you can't afford, you can't access higher education here in Kenya and in many other countries of Africa. You can only get yourself into higher institutions of learning if you have money, or you have a scholarship, or you have a family friend who decides to pay your tuition fee. And paying tuition fee here in Africa and other parts of the world is not enough. After paying tuition fee, there is living expenses, accommodation, food, clothing. Those are also additional expenses which can let someone drop out of university or from higher learning institutions. So, higher education is very expensive in most parts of the world. But New York State in America has set the trend on what should happen. Should we go for free education, free university education, or should we continue paying? In Kenya, since 2003, during the National Rainbow Coalition administration, free education was introduced in Kenya. This was in an effort to provide universal basic education to everyone in the country. And Kenya became one of the leading countries around the world where universal basic education was performing well. More and more people were getting into the schooling system in primary schools. Now, the Jubilee Party, which is the ruling party as we speak, has promised that from January 2018, they will be providing free secondary education to all students in secondary schools. What next? Will there be a political party in future which will declare that we are providing free secondary education like the Labour Party did in the United Kingdom? In their manifesto in 2017, they said we will abolish fees entirely. Is this where we are heading? Already we are providing free primary education, free secondary education. We start next year in January. What would be next? Are we heading to a point where we provide free higher education? Once you pass from secondary school, you pass your Kenya Certificate of Secondary Education, you join a university of your choice, then you study for free. No tuition. We are yet to see. So, English higher education system has seen it all. Au watu wa United Kingdom wametoka mbali. Walianza bila kulipa malipo ya tuition fee. Hawakuwa wanalipa tuition fee. It was free. It is called no fee. Then they moved to Roe Head University. And now tuition fee is being charged in the United Kingdom. They have come from far. They started with no fee. They moved to low aid. And now tuition fee stands at 9,000 British pounds per year. That is lots of money. That's lots of money. 9,000 British pounds is a lots of money. That's an equivalent of 1.2 million Kenyan shillings per year. Plenty of money. In Kenya, we pay an approximate of 1,000 British pounds per year to access university education. That is averagely around 150,000 Kenyan shillings. It also depends on the course. The tuition fee changes from course to course. So compare 1,000 British pounds here in Kenyan university, for example, if you are pursuing a Bachelor of Economics, a Bachelor of Commerce, a Bachelor of Education. Actually, Bachelor of Education is even cheaper, something like 120,000 Kenyan shillings, which is less than 1,000 British pounds. It is cheaper to attend higher education here in Kenya compared to England or United Kingdom or Britain. Research shows that England has moved from free higher education system to a high fee, high aid system, university enrollment has increased substantially, despite the increase in high fee or paying high fee. We have seen it is 1.2 million Kenyan shillings. Still, enrollment has been increasing. So this has been a paradox for researchers. So some three professors decided to do a research. They conducted a research to find out why. Despite the fact that now students are paying higher fees as tuition fee, what has changed? What's happening? Why is it that more students from the poorest backgrounds have enrolled over the period under focus? Why? How comes when there is higher fees paid, more and more students from poor families are coming on board? They conducted the research and came up with the findings. They discovered that this has been attributed to complete coverage of tuition fee by a government loan. So equally in United Kingdom, just like in Kenya, where some students who have passed from high school, those who have passed have reached a certain pass mark, they get student loans, government loans. The same case happens in United Kingdom. Students from poor backgrounds get a student loan. Loans for living costs have risen each year, even in the United Kingdom. So they get a loan for tuition fee, they get another loan for living costs, and students in the United Kingdom can safely borrow against their future income. You know, when you borrow today, you are borrowing against your future income. One day when you start earning your money, that is where the government will get you. They will now start deducting your future income. At that point, your future income will be deducted. It will be less than what you could have received if it were that you don't have a loan. Now, in the United Kingdom, there is heavily insured loans which are available for students. But these heavily insured loans are not available in other countries like the United Kingdom, the United States, Australia, and other countries. So it is a kind of a university financing framework which is working for the people in the United Kingdom. I know each and every framework comes with its own challenges, but it is working for the people in Britain. Probably we need to go there and borrow some lessons. What should we do to make sure that more and more people get to the higher institutions of learning instead of them being marginalized? We know that charging a tuition fee in universities has been one way of increasing inequality in those institutions of higher learning. The rich, those who are capable of paying, get more access to those universities compared to the poor who cannot access. Let us continue having this debate in this comment section below. And make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. Up to this point, thank you for tuning in to Kerosi TV. Until we see you next time on the internet, bye for now.